Hello students, how are you all of you? Welcome again in our second video lecture for the chapter Hello Alkanes and Haloarenes. Right? In this video lecture, we are going to study about the IUPAC nomenclature, that is IUPAC nomenclature system for Hello Alkanes and Haloarenes, as well as we are going to study the nature of CX bond, that is carbon and halogen bond, in this video lecture. Right? So first we are going to study the method of nomenclature of haloalkanes and haloarenes. Right? So we'll see the nomenclature of haloalkanes and haloarenes. As we know that how to name any organic compound, there is one basic rule. First of all, you have to identify the parent carbon chain, right? Here it is mentioned that to locate the parent alkyl chain, right? What is the number of carbons or what is the longest carbon chain you are finding out? Here you can see the longest chain is of 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So total there are 5 carbons, so you can name it as a pentane. Later on, we have to see where these functional groups are situated. Right? We have to find out where this position of individual functional group is present. You can see bromine here, it is present on 3rd carbon. Right? And on 2nd carbon, there is methyl group. Right? So you can name it as 3-bromo. Right, on 3 there is bromine, so 3-bromo. Second there is methyl group, so 2-methyl. And our parent carbon chain is pentane. So at last we'll write the parent carbon chain of alkane, that is pentane. Right. Similarly, the rule here it is mentioned, you have to locate the parent chain as well as you have to number the parent chain to give the substituent, or you can say functional groups which are present in the first lower number. In our textbook it is mentioned as lowest set of locants, means where the functional group is getting the least number, you accordingly you have to number the carbon chain. Right? Similarly, show the halogen substituents by either naming by prefixes like fluoro, chloro, bromo and iodo. For fluorine atoms, either chlorine, bromine or iodine, you have to name them in alphabetical sequence. There's important criteria. See, you can see here the bromine is mentioned first because the bromo B is alphabet which is coming before the M alphabet. So basis on that we are naming these functional groups, and even locate each halogen atom present on the parent chain, means on what carbon it is present. Here bromine is present on 3rd carbon, so to mention the location or position of halogen atom. Similarly, here another example is given for alicyclic. We are numbering 1st carbon here because we know that according to reactivity series, or we can say priority series, the double bond is more reactive than halogens. So first we are giving priority to double bond. This is 1st carbon, 2nd, 3rd and 4th carbon. Right? So here we are writing as 4-bromo. On 4th carbon there is bromine. This compound is cyclohexene. Right? Cyclic, it is alicyclic. So we are mentioning 4-bromo cyclohexene. Right? This is one of the example given here. Same way, next is some examples are mentioned here. You can see how to name these compounds. For example, here it is fluorine containing haloalkane, and there is single one carbon chain CH3. So you can commonly name it as methyl fluoride. Remember, methyl fluoride is a common name. Whenever you are saying alkyl halide, then alkyl halide stands for common name, And when you are mentioning haloalkane, like you can see here fluoromethane, that would be an IUPAC name, right? So first you have to focus which halogen atom is present, right? Either fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine. And that becomes the second half of the name of the compound, right? Similarly, as you discussed, the carbon branch attached to the halogen is named as usual, just like alkanes, and becomes the first half name of the structure. Here it is mentioned for common name, methyl, that is first half name, and fluoride, that is the second half name, that is method for common nomenclature. In IUPAC, first we are mentioning the name of halogen atom like fluorine or bromine, chlorine or iodine, and later on we are mentioning the carbon chain, either methane, ethane, propane, butane and so on. You can see here in second example, the common name is ethyl bromide. First we are mentioning this carbon chain ethyl, like any general alkyl chain in common system, and then we are writing name of the halogen as halide, that is fluoride, chloride, bromide or iodide, that is for common system. While in IUPAC name, we are writing first the name of the halogen as bromo, and later on the carbon chain, that is alkane. Here it is two carbons, so it is ethane, right? Similarly, one more example is given here. First you have to see the longest chain. You can see here the longest chain, it becomes of three carbons, right? First carbon, second or third. You can also mention like this, first carbon, second carbon or third carbon. So ultimately it becomes propane, three carbons. Now you have to number the carbons. Either you can number it as first one, second one and third one. So on second there is iodine, as well as on second carbon there is methyl. So you can name it as, on two there is iodine, so 2-iodo, and on two there is methyl group, so 2-methyl, and at last our parent carbon chain, that is propane, so we'll name it as 2-iodo 2-methyl propane, right? That is IUPAC name. And common name, you can see here, here this total functional group which is present, that you can observe here, this is tertiary butyl functional group, right? Total there are four carbons, and the central carbon is tertiary carbon, so here it is written tertiary butyl iodide, right? This is common name for this given structure. Right. Next is, you can see some more similar examples mentioned here, like chloromethane, which is an IUPAC nomenclature. In common name, you can say it is methyl chloride. Chloromethane is a common name in IUPAC system. Similarly, here it is mentioned common IUPAC, as well as which class of compound is present. Class means either it can be primary, or either it can be secondary, or it can be tertiary. Right? So basis on that, it is mentioned here. Same way, some examples mentioned like iodine containing cyclic compound. It is iodocyclohexane in IUPAC system. In common name, you can mention as cyclohexyl iodide. This total group is mentioned as cyclohexyl in common system. The type of, or you can say class of compound, is secondary, because the iodine which is attached over here, that carbon is secondary carbon, right? Again, this structure is similar. Likewise, here there was iodine, here now it is bromine. So you can write it as tertiary butyl bromide, or you can write in IUPAC as the longest chain of three carbons, that is propane, and on second carbon there is bromine, and on second carbon that is methyl group. This one is also belonging to class tertiary because the central carbon is tertiary carbon, right? So the next structure mentioned here, it is a cyclopentane, and this is your central carbon on which there are two groups. One is methyl functional group, second is chlorine functional group. So you can write it as either methyl cyclopentyl chloride, it is methyl cyclopentyl chloride, or in IUPAC system PO2 mention this as first carbon, central carbon is first carbon, and on this carbon there is chlorine and methyl. So here it is mentioned 1-chloro-1-methyl-cyclopentane, right? This 1-chloro-1-methyl, and this is totally cyclopentane, right? And this belongs to class tertiary. You can see here the central carbon is linked with three carbons, first, second, and third. So this central carbon is bonded with three carbons, so it is belonging to tertiary class of compound, right? Here some other common compounds are mentioned. Commonly they are used as solvents, right? Industrial solvents. So some of them are mentioned with common names, or you can say trivial names. Generally by common names, how they are known as, first is dichloromethane. It contains two chlorines, is commonly known as methylene chloride, right? Dichloromethane, which is one of the very good solvent, non-polar solvent. Second is trichloromethane. It is containing three chlorine atoms, trichloro. Commonly, as we know, it is known as chloroform, right? Same way, another compound is 1,1,1-trichloroethane, right? There are three chlorines, known as methyl chloroform. It is common name. Same way, trichloroethylene is known as trichlor. It is again one of the very good solvents. Some of them, like this trichlor and dichloromethane, they are also used as dry cleaning agents, right? They are very good used for removal of the stains, right? They are mentioned here. Next is nomenclature for aromatics. See, as we know that in benzene it is a cyclic compound, so we have to see where these functional groups are present. In common system we are naming them as ortho, meta and para, right? Ortho position, meta position and para position. So first, suppose there is one R group already present on benzene, then these two positions are considered as ortho, right? That is, first nearby positions are ortho, next to them it is meta position. On third carbons, you can say this is third position, first, second and third. So third position are meta positions. Fourth one, that is para position, right? You can see here these two A and B groups are located in ortho position, that is first and second positions. Here it is first and third position, that is meta. Same way, first and fourth, it is para position. Some examples are given here. You can see if there is bromine attached on benzene ring, you can simply name it as bromobenzene, right? Even the common name is similar, bromobenzene. And in previous system they were also naming them, these compounds, like phenyl bromide. Again, it is a common name, phenyl bromide is a in common system, while in IUPAC it is bromobenzene. Similarly, you can note here the position is first and third, right? So it is meta position. So in common name you can write it as meta dibromo benzene, because there are two bromines on meta position. and compulsorily in IUPAC we have to mention the numbers of carbon atoms around the benzene. So here it is first, second and third. So on 1 and 3 there is bromine atom. So compulsorily in IUPAC system we have to give numbers like 1,3 dibromo benzene, right? Similarly, this structure, there are 3 bromines on 1st, 3rd and 5th carbon. So you can name it as 1,3,5 tribromo benzene, or you can name it as symmetric sim tribromo benzene, right? Here another structure is mentioned. Chlorine is attached on this carbon chain. As we know the rule, the longest carbon chain is of 3 carbons, either 1st, 2nd, 3rd or even 1st, 2nd and 3rd, but we will give this carbon first number because halogen is attached on this first carbon, right? So 1, 2 and 3. On 1 there is chloro, so 1 chloro. On 2 there are 2 methyl groups, so 2,2 dimethyl. You can see here 2,2 dimethyl, 1 chloro, so on 1 there is chlorine, and 2,2 dimethyl, on second carbon 2 methyl group, and longest chain is of propane, right? You can see propane, so it is 2,2 dimethyl propane. So even you can name it in common system, you can observe this total part. This much part is neopentane, right? Neopentane. You can observe here this total, there are 5 carbons situated here, right? And there is chlorine, so you can name it also as neopentyl chloride, but that would be in common system, common nomenclature. Similarly, in this structure you can see there are 3 carbons, that is propane, and 1st, 2nd and 3rd carbon, and 2nd there is bromine, so it is 2 bromo propane, right? This is the nomenclature system for dihalides. Dihalides means where the compound contains 2 halogen atoms. You can see here there are 2 chlorines on one same carbon. Same way here the 2 chlorine are present on different carbon atoms. So in this they are classified into 2 types. One are known as geminal dihalide. Geminal means the halogen is present on same carbon, that is geminal. And if the halogens are attached on 2 different carbons, they are known as vicinal, right? In short, they are known as geminal and vicinal dihalides. You can see here in IUPAC system, as we know, we have to number the carbon where halogen is present. So on 1st carbon there are 2 chlorine atoms, so 1,1 dichloroethane, 2 carbon, so it is a ethane carbon chain. And in common system it is known as geminal dihalide. But there is one specific thing here, the geminal are named as alkylidene dihalides, alkylidene halides. So here alkylidene is named as ethylidene chloride, right? The halide is chlorine, so here it is ethylidene chloride, right? Same way in vicinal, there is again specific thing, the vicinal commonly they are named as alkylene dihalide, right? You can see the difference. Here it is alkylidene, while the vicinal are named as alkylene dihalides. So here this 2 carbon chain ethane is mentioned as ethylidene, it is ethylene dichloride, right? The dihalide is mentioned here as dichloride, and this alkylene is mentioned as ethylene dichloride, right? And IUPAC, as we know, we have to give numbers to the position of halogen atoms. In 1st carbon and 2nd carbon, there are 2 chlorines, so it is 1,2 dichloroethane. But here you can see it is on the same carbon atom, so you can name it as 1,1 dichloroethane, right? It is on the same carbon, 1,1 dichloroethane. So that is the difference between two types of dihaloalkanes. It is one of the important thing you should remember, right? And this is a table I have taken from the textbook. Here are some of the IUPAC names mentioned here and some of the common names mentioned for the structure. You can see this compound here, it is secondary butyl. The central carbon is secondary carbon, and on that there is chlorine, so you can write it as secondary butyl chloride. That is common name. As we know, in IUPAC there is numbering system. On second carbon there is chlorine, so 2-chlorobutane is mentioned. Same way we have seen this neopentyl bromide, that is 1-bromo-2,2-dimethylpropane, name of the structure. And similarly, we have seen this tertiary butyl bromide in previous slides. And these two types we have seen during classification in our previous lecture, video lecture. We have seen vinyl as well as allyl. These are in common system, but in IUPAC name we have to just follow the same rule. The longest carbon chain, lowest set of locants, and halogens are written in prefix. You can see in first here it is chlorine atom, so it is named as chloro, and it is two carbon having double bond, so it is ethene, chloro ethene. Here in common system it is allyl bromide, but in IUPAC we have to give first number to double bond, second and third. So on third there is bromine, right? This is first carbon based on priority series. There is double bond more reactive, so 1, 2, and 3. And three there is bromine, so 3-bromopropene. 3-bromopropene, right? Same way another compound. This is orthochlorotoluene in common name. But in IUPAC we have to give the number in ortho position. It is 1-2 position. So in 1 there is chlorine, 2 there is methyl. So 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene, 1-chloro-2-methyl-benzene, or 2-chloro-toluene, and 2 there is chlorine, and overall it is known also as toluene methyl benzene. So 2-chloro-toluene. Same way, the common name for this structure is benzyl chloride, right? Benzyl chloride. This much part benzene, and this CH2 is benzyl group. This chlorine, so it is benzyl chloride. But in IUPAC, we are naming this carbon chain as more priority, because halogen substituent is present on the carbon chain. So here it is considered as chloromethane. On this methane there is phenyl ring. So here it is mentioned chloro phenyl methane. You can see why methane, because this is one carbon, so it is methane. And on this one carbon there is chlorine as well as phenyl group, so it is chloro phenyl and methane, right? That is in IUPAC system. Similarly, some other examples like methylene chloride, it is for dichloromethane. In IUPAC it is dichloro, chloroform, right, having 3 chlorines. In IUPAC it is trichloromethane. Same way, 3-bromine, it is known as bromoform, right? If there are 3 halogen and 1 carbon in common, they are known as haloform. 3 halogens and 1 carbon, that is haloform. If there is chlorine, then chloroform. bromine then bromo form, if iodine then iodo form respectively. You can see here IUPAC name is tribromo methane, it is similar. And if there are four chlorines, here in common name it is carbon tetrachloride, in IUPAC it is tetrachloro methane tetra, because four chlorine are present. Same way the structure is propyl fluoride, normal propyl. Normal means there is no branching, it is a linear, so normal propyl fluoride. In IUPAC it is 1-fluoropropane, because on first carbon there is fluorine atom, right? So it is 1-fluoropropane. These are some of the important common and IUPAC names mentioned here. Here also some more new examples are given. These are given in bond line structures. You can see there are two carbons and chlorine, so it is simply chloroethane, or in common you can name it as ethyl chloride. You have seen this previously. Same way three carbon, and on central carbon there is bromine, so it is isopropyl bromide. Isopropyl, it is in common name. In IUPAC it is 2-bromopropane. On second carbon there is bromine atom. Longest carbon is 3 carbon chain, first, second, third, so it is 2-bromopropane. Same way cyclohexyl chloride, common name for this compound, chlorine containing, it is alicyclic. And in IUPAC it is chlorocyclohexane, right? Same way one more structure given. In this, first of all you have to find out where it is forming longest carbon chain. You can see here it is forming a pentane by naming this carbon as first carbon, second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon and fifth carbon. So total there are 5 carbons, so it is pentane, right? On second there is bromine, so here it is written 2-bromo. And on this third carbon there is methyl group, there is branching, so 3-methyl. And there are total 5 carbons, so it is pentene actually, pentene, because on third there is double bond, so pent 3-ene, right? You can see on third carbon there is double bond, so pent 3-ene, right? 2-bromo, 3-methyl, pent 3-ene. You have to first select the longest chain. You see here also they have also selected the lowest set of locants they have considered, right? Next one, here it is mentioned, you have to find out, you have to select the longest chain. You can see the longest chain is of 4 carbon, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And first one there is bromine, right? So 1-bromo. And second one there is methyl group, right? So 2-methyl, 1-bromo, 2-methyl butane. Why butane? Because the longest chain is of 4 carbon, so it is butane. And first there is bromine, so 1-bromo, 2 there is methyl, so 2-methyl. Longest chain is propane, right? Same way some more examples are given. You can see it is 1,3-dibromopropane. And first and third there is bromine. Here you can see 1,2-dibromopropane, and 1 and 2 there are bromine atoms. Here it is 1,1-dibromopropane. On first carbon there are 2 bromines, and here 2,2-dibromobutane, because on second carbon there are 2 bromine atoms, right? Right, so similarly some more examples are given here, right? The compounds are mentioned and the IUPAC names are also mentioned. You can go through this compounds. Even some of the practice problems are also mentioned here. You can go through this practice problems. They are based on your syllabus, right? Some more practice questions are mentioned here. You can go through this, so you can work out on this practice questions and problems which are mentioned here, right? Even some more structures are mentioned. You have to write the IUPAC names of these compounds, right? So we are ending the lecture here, right? Thank you for joining this online session, right? Thank you very much. Have a nice day.